blah, 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 blah. Oh, good. I got an email from people. But... Meow. How now, meow, meow. Mew, mew. What am I doing in the world? Guess I need to set up for
everyone come.
I want to turn on the light really quick. I'm not going to get it. Dark. Hard for me to get it from this angle.
No, you're good. We don't have to do it.
Okay. Sounds like it's coming from the front of the house to me.
Oh.
Like, all the time.
Echo.
I guess. Give me that good echo. Give me that good Amazon echo.
I love it so much, honey. I just... Dakota's glitched the wrong side of her butt. Oh, wow. I thought I was done with this when I saved the other night. That's why I saved. Let's chainsaw you, buddy.
Filled with super mutants, so that's fun. I guess maybe they're gonna take over. I guess that's an improvement, right? Brotherhood instead of, you know, mutants. That was a joke, by the way. I was totally kidding. Didn't really mean it. And if the Brotherhood is listening, I'm sure.
You know what it sounds like to me usually? It sounds like someone's struggling with our screen door.
Keep a knocking.
But it trips me out so bad.
It's short and it's about telling people to go away. Oh, movie.
Is there a way to see who I gave a place to? I guess not.
Pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packin' mama, lay that pistol down.
Geez, sorry, dog meat.
Was I having fun? Till one night she caught me right.
Is sure beat spending your whole life growing shitty crops just to wind up. Pistol down. Pistol packin' mama, lay that pistol down.
Every night, Bing, and I'll woo you every day. I'll be your regular mama, and I'll put that gun away. Oh, lay that
pistol down, babe. Lay that pistol down. Pistol packing, mama. Lay the thing down before it goes off and hurts somebody. Oh, she kicked out my windshield and she hit me over the head. She cussed and cried and said I'd lied and she wished that I was dead.
Oh, lay that pistol down, babe. Lay that pistol down. Pistol packing, mama. Lay that pistol down with three tough gals. From deep down Texas way, we got the pals. They don't like the way we play. We're a rough, rootin', tootin', shootin' trio, but you've seen my sister Cleo. She's a terror, make no error, but there ain't no laissez-faire. Here's what we tell her.
Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol baggin' mama, lay that pistol down.
The draw was slow, so now they know you can't do that to Maine.
Oh, lay that pistol down, babe. Lay that pistol down.
Pistol packing, mama.
Lay that pistol down. Oh, singing songs in a cabaret. Was I having fun? Till one night it didn't seem right.
Girls! Girls! Watch out! Watch out! There's a two-legged animal running about.
Rice.
If it's smart, it's a cigar. And it hangs around at a bar.
What the hell's going on?
Scratch. If it's stubborn as can be, mean and ornery.
Burn him down.
If it walks, if it talks,
they thought they had a chance.
If it brags and tries to make you think it's wonderful, don't let it fool ya. If it takes the moon up on high, more than if it kisses you and you find you like it, to grab it. It's a man. If it whistles each time you pass, owns a car that runs out of gas, then it's time that you get happy. Better watch your step. It's a man. If it acts just like it's the boss, when it knows that you are of course. If it gets a little rough, thinks it's very tough. It's a man. If it walks, if it talks, if its habits are a little bit peculiar, if it brags and tries to make you think it's wonderful, be on the lookout. Don't let it fool you. But if it's kneeling down on one knee,
just hitting my guy.
Can't furnish it with love. Grow mushroom trees and tummy fees and content colors.
I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony.
Perfect harmony.
I'd like to buy the world a new game and company.
Best in talk, sports, drama, and music. Atomic Radio.
Assassin's Creed. Perfect.
Boy, is it good to be home. Everything's just how I remember. Doc's Diamond, and right next to the old drugstore. The people are the same, too. There's Bill, the barber, Martha, the grocer, and Charlie, the racist.
Guess we're clear for now.
I guess they still haven't proven those costumes were his. And frankly, they probably never will. That's because nothing ever changes in Springfield.
Connie! It's good to have you back. Where have you been?
Costa Rica. Working with animals, mostly. Magnificent creatures you'll find there.
Sounds wonderful. What brings you to town?
I don't know. I felt homesick.
And you just hopped a plane back here?
Yeah.
Well, you probably should have given your family some warning. Given them time to prepare for your homecoming.
Why? I thought they might like it if I surprised them.
Really, that's not a good idea. You should call them first. Why don't we use the phone over here?
Now you're acting strange. Why should I call them first? What's going on?
I don't know how to tell you this, so I won't. Why don't you go home and talk to your sister?
Come back home.
Well, no, not usually. But after the drugs and the mental institution, we thought...
What drugs? What institution? I've been in Costa Rica.
Oh, Connie, your doctor said you might have delusions. Things to fill the gaps in time. I mean, could you even point out Costa Rica on a map?
Sure. It's right next to Arizona somewhere.
I'm afraid not, sweetie.
Are you calling me a liar? Where's Dad? He'll tell you.
Connie... You don't remember? You murdered your father right in this very room, and we've been trying to cover it up ever since.
I murdered him? Oh my God, is that what caused me to lose my mind?
Well, no. You were actually dealing with it quite well, but then you started
making... Badging, shooting down a bunch of flying ants with a gun. Weird. Very weird.
Did I kill her? Did that put me over the edge?
That, or the pills, or that weird cult you joined. Look, the point is, it's really awkward when you come home and I have to explain this to you every time. If you called, I could have made up some story, like Dan and Sammy went out fishing.
He went fishing, huh? And he didn't even invite me. I'm gonna kill him. It's the same old story in Springfield. Everything's just how I remember.
Infestation. CNN.
Lady, see you kill monster. You, friend.
Oh, God. Let me guess. You were raised by apes.
Not no ape. You kill monster alone. Sito happy you kill monster.
Can't believe you couldn't handle that thing yourself.
Not one monster.
Yeah, right? You look like Khal Drogo. How come you couldn't kill these gator monsters?
New monster comes. Sito kill monsters no.
Uh-huh. I knew this would be a pain in the ass.
Sito not doctor. Make new friend.
Mm-hmm.
Sito show you.
Sure, man. So.
Reserve your ticket now and be the first to ride our.
And now a message from our sponsors.
Opening soon at Safari Adventure.
School's out for the day, and some of the boys want to go to the vacant lot to play catch. Not today, fellas, Gary tells them. I've got to be home before dark. Gary's got a lot on his mind, you see. Not only is his book report due next week, but the communists might invade America, and he doesn't know an ounce of Chinese. Don't worry, Gary. You won't have to translate that report anytime soon. That's fallout will annihilate your school long before you ever set foot in it.
That was quick.
Not to worry. While your school will be turned to dust, you and your family will be safe and secure in your government.
They should leave it at the door. Unfortunately, I just got over. Alone, or if I turn the mics in. I'd rather just sit closer to my own mic right now. Oops. all time.
Fancy.
I love this place. It feels like I'm at the Rainforest Cafe.
Every fall residence is pre-screened and selected to ensure maximum compatibility. Inside, you'll find people who share your ideals.
Going in, man? Okay.
Even your looks.
Should I go in without you?
Another you, Gary, but it very well could be. Meanwhile, those boys out in the vacant lot, the only balls they'll be catching are the ones falling out of their eye sockets. Don't let your children end up like these boys. Make sure they're like Gary, and contact your local Vault Tech representative today.
Sito.
This home. This family. No worry. They not hurt you. You friend Sito mean you friend family.
The best in talk, sports, drama, and music. Atomic Radio.
How did you end up being raised by these gorillas?
Sito very small when first family died. First family look like Sito. Sito not die. Just walk and walk. Find zoo place. Find new family. New family help Sito. Give Sito food. Give water. Keep Sito safe. Now Sito big and strong. Sito help family fight monsters.
Look, it doesn't apply to everything. The point is, I'm a tough guy. What do you want, father?
Your confession. Also, you're double parked, and I need the space.
Great. I always wanted to be best friends with a bunch of gorillas.
Sito glad new friend like family. Now you help Sito. Family in danger. Hide here from here have no food. Here. Sito kill many.
We've got the baddest bullies in the baddest harbor in the world. And you? You ain't so bad.
It's okay, Sito. So we'll take so care of your family.
Sito like new friend. Sito
so
have story.
I'm a nice guy.
Story helps stop monsters. Sito eat with
saying?
Family. Wrinkly
you know
man come
are.
Inside
in
home.
Fact, one of them right
wrinkly
room,
man
we all
hurt.
Know who he is, but
Sito
what a
try
name.
Help.
And
wrinkly
why?
Man
he'll
say
shoot us?
He make
well,
monsters. Sito mad at wrinkly
no
man.
Right
monsters hurt family. Wrinkly man sorry monsters hurt family. He give Sito shiny thing. He say shiny thing help Sito stop monsters. Sito try help more, but wrinkly man die. Now give shiny thing.
And now,
A word from our... Why say lot words, Sito, when few do trick?
Whether you're searching for a new piece of jewelry or an entire wardrobe, Fallon's department store is the place to go. With multiple locations throughout the...
This is Dr. Darren McDermott, last known survivor at the Safari Adventure Replication Facility. This is my final recording. I've done something horrible. The thing I created, the thing I called the Gator Claw, they must be destroyed. They can't be tamed. They can't be controlled. Their sheer ferocity is like nothing I've ever seen. And now, the new replicator is out of control. It's producing them at an alarming rate. Please, somebody, anybody, find my passcode. Or Dr. Hines. Shut down the replicator before it's...
You should say your passcode in this, though. For real. Are you Dr. Hine?
Dead man have important thing?
Huh. So it seems like the Gator Claws, or the monsters, are coming from an animal cloning facility somewhere beneath Safari Adventure.
Shiny thing, help, new friend.
You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do?
Do you know anything about a cloning facility around here?
New friend say strange words. Sito not know what new friend want, but Sito know. Sito see wrinkly man go to big triangle house. Find cloning facility. Sito come with.
I've been sitting on a fence, and it doesn't make much sense, cause you keep me in suspense. And you
no, stay with your family. I've got this.
Sito stay.
Well, I guess I'll never learn, and I show it. If you've got a heart, and if you're kind, then don't keep us apart. Make up your mind. You're undecided now. So what are you gonna do?
Well, that was Captain America's shield from a distance. Up, I just take this guy's only note that he doesn't understand. Awesome.
I've been sitting on a fence, and it doesn't make much sense, cause you keep me in suspense, and you know it. Then you promise to return, when you don't, I really burn. Well, I guess I'll never learn, and I show it. If you got a heart, and if you're kind, and don't keep us apart, make up your mind. You're undecided now, so what are you gonna do?
Now if
you don't love me, I wish you'd say so. I love you so much, honey, I just got to know. I'm just a fool for you.
Weather turns on a dime at Nuka World.
And now, a word from our sponsors. Every morning, we at Pinelli's Bakery wake up at the break of dawn, bright and early. In fact, we open our doors before most customers open their eyes. We're heating the ovens, kneading the dough, making sure that every muffin, pastry, and loaf of bread
scores
is
for star control
fresh
are
by
now
the time
full for the day.
Most
we speak
people
to a
concierge
for additional
They've
information.
To expect that we'll be there with a smile on our face, no matter how many times you angrily berate us. And that's okay, because in the food service industry, we understand there's no room for basic human decency. At Pinelli's Bakery, we're here to serve you.
Oh, but I'm gonna fight this thing.
The best in talk, sports, drama, and music. Atomic Radio.
Why is there caution? Is the tree alive? It looks pretty alive.
I don't want you to leave, Rick.
Look, Mary, I'm a bartender. You know damn well that means I have to work nights.
But you heard the news reports? They're calling in the Boston Butcher, and he's already killed half of the women all over Lexington.
We don't know that for sure. And the way you're acting, I'd say it's working.
Oh, please, Rick, stay with me. It'll just be for tonight.
That's what you said last night. And the night before. I've already used all my food dates. Do you want me to lose my job, too?
All right. But promise you'll come home as soon as your shift is over.
Jesus, Mary. I'll be home when the work's done. Not a moment sooner.
Excellent.
Who is it?
I'm afraid of your husband. He asked me to check up on you, make sure you're all right.
Oh, that was nice of him. I have to admit, I'm a bit of a wreck. Do you work at the bar?
That's right, Fred Sampson. Your husband probably mentioned me before.
He doesn't like to talk about work.
That's funny. I can't get him to shut up. He's part of the reason I volunteered to check on you. He said you were frightened by that whole business in the papers.
Are you talking about the butcher?
Sure, but I'm afraid I haven't been following it as closely as you have. What do you know about him?
It's all in today's issue of the Bugle. Go on, read it.
Wow. It says here you killed 6 women, all redheads in their 20s. Say, you're a redhead.
That's right.
And you're about 25, right?
22.
Huh. Now I see why you're worried.
It's not just that. If you read further down, there was also an eyewitness who saw him leave the building of one of the victims. They said he was a Caucasian man, about 6 feet tall, with blonde hair and blue eyes. And I've seen at least 3 men that fit that description living on this street alone.
6 feet tall, blonde hair and blue eyes. Hey, come to think of it, I fit that description.
It also mentions he has a bit of a limp.
I've got a bum leg from a shrapnel wound I got in Korea.
And one other detail. They said he carved the letters FS on the bedpost of one of his victims. The police think it might be his initials, like Frank Smith.
Or Fred Sampson.
One of the detectives said there was
Isn't the little town I found, Brad Burton? That's weird.
Entered the homes pretending to be a friend or a relative, or a spouse's co-worker. Sort of like the way you and Rick know each other.
Hold on. You don't think people are going to say I'm the butcher, do you?
You? But why? You're Fred Sampson, Rick's friend from work.
And your landlord saw me come up to this room. He could be calling the police right now.
Now, why would he do that? Fred, what's the matter?
I think I'd better go.
Wait, what you can't leave. What if the butcher comes? What if he's here in this building?
Let go of my arm, lady.
You mustn't go. Please.
Did you hear? They found the butcher.
Really? Where?
Hang them some.
We, the members of AFAD, have an important message for those. Psst, Chipmunk, tell them what our name means.
What are you doing? I have the thing running right now.
Don't just say AFAD. Tell them what it stands for.
I'm trying to do something serious here, Rabbit, and I already have the recording started.
We'll take this out of the recording later. Just tell them.
Fine. We, the members of the Animal Friends and Defenders, have an important message to those who are causing the destruction of the environment. Will not stand idly by and watch our animal brothers and sisters get hunted to extinction. We will take action. We will not remain complacent while corporations abuse our animal brothers and sisters in the name of so-called science. We will take action. We will not turn our backs as... Oh, don't forget the part about slaughtering the animals needlessly for food. No one recording, right? You see that red light, yeah? I'm sorry, Jimonk. Just try to, you know. Toss that tape, and we'll try again. And when we're done, don't throw out the good tape and keep the bad one like last time.
I say I'll move the mountains, and I'll move the mountains if he wants them out of the way. Crazy calls me. Sure, I'm crazy, crazy in love, I'd say. I say I'll go through fire, and I'll go through fire as he wants it, so it will be. Crazy calls me. Sure, I'm crazy. Crazy in love, you see. Like the wind that shakes the
porque porky
me with a smile. The difficult I'll do right now. The impossible will take a little while. I say I'll care forever, and I mean forever, if I have to hold up the sky. Crazy he calls me. Sure I'm crazy, crazy in love. Am I like the wind that shakes the bough? He moves me.
Where I go? I guess I should ask him the thing, but I'd also like to ignore him.
I'll do right now. The impossible will take a little while. I say I'll care forever, and I mean forever, if I have
you
to
good
hold
fighter
up yeah. The sky.
That's a smell you don't forget. Better not stick to us.
Crazy.
It seems like Dr. Hine was kidnapped and taken somewhere called the Angry Anaconda. We find that, and we can find his passcode to get into the cloning facility.
Sounds like name of snake from old zoo.
Oh, maybe Dr. Under Giant Metal Snake.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
I'm sure you know exactly where that is, Sito.
Yes, Sito, no. It's big. What? Ride like big snake.
Sure.
And uphill behind Sue.
Pedestrians, lane changes, intermittent rain.
How did you know an anaconda was a kind of snake, Sito?
Sito try learn words from Sue. Sito see pictures in house with snakes look like big metal snake on hill. Sito.
Red Racer. Red Racer, the leader in automotive parts and performance.
You're listening to Atomic Radio, the number one AM station in all of Boston.
Honey, do you mind setting the table?
Sure, but, we need to talk first. I'm afraid I've got...
Good job, Sito.
Here. What's wrong?
Sito, help.
I got laid off.
Sito,
today.
Like, help.
Oh, no, that's terrible. Did you at least get a severance?
Not a dime.
Well, chin up. It's not the end of the world. I'm sure you'll be back on your feet in no time.
I've been fired from 3 straight jobs, Steph. The word's gotten around town. No one's gonna hire me now.
We have our life insurance policies. It's not an endowment, but it's something.
A few hundred dollars is gonna be enough.
Coming with me?
One of us.
Sito.
Has to die.
Sito strong. Sito protect
wouldn't be
family.
Such a bad idea.
Sito
don't talk
strong.
Like that. I'd be lost
Sito
without you.
Protect family.
All right, I guess I can't tell him to follow at all anymore.
Well, Mr. Trent is your insurance auditor, I have to be honest. This whole affair is mighty suspicious. You lose your job, your bills are piling up, and the very next day your wife disappears.
I don't like where you're going with this. Are you saying I killed her?
Maybe. No, she could have left. Maybe the two of you are working together. Either way, I have 7 years to find out. That's 7 years before a missing person is presumed dead. Do you think you can hold out for that long?
Actually, most murders are solved within 48 hours.
Are you admitting you murdered your wife?
I wasn't talking about my wife.
Mr. Trent, you realize why we're here, don't you? First your wife goes missing, and then the insurance auditor assigned to your case.
I don't see what's so strange about it. People
Noodle
disappear
World is pleased
all the
to
time.
Announce that a small so portion of your admission fee will be donated to support our men and women fighting overseas.
Wife I get, but according to our records, you'd never even met the auditor before.
So, he was old and out of shape. It didn't take a genius to see he was gonna die.
According to our records, the auditor was young and out of shape.
Up in Redwood 7 years ago, an entire town disappeared without a trace. People thought it was haunted. There were no witnesses, no bodies. No one had to figure out how the whole thing went down. We told the customer once again, multiple followers for over $1 million. First thing I did was look at the addresses. And guess what? They're all from Redwood. It's been 7 years. Means none of them were presumed dead until today. But what I don't understand, Barry, is who turned these in. I've been here all morning, and I haven't seen a single customer walk through those doors.
I wasn't talking about a customer.
I don't want that at all. Should not have picked that weird thing up. B. Ross, Bob Ross?
Hello.
worry, worry, love is passing me by. Worry, 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 I'm so painfully shy. Love the guys, get all the kisses.
Why am I the one who misses?
Worry, 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 woe is me. Baby, 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 I'm a fool about love. Maybe, maybe I should go to school about love. When it comes to getting chummy,
I'll admit I'm quite a dummy.
Worry, 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 woe is me. I found out that I'm the worrying kind. I go worrying right along.
Let me into the world.
It's fine, but with the worry in mind.
So many things can go wrong.
Worry, 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 should I hold her so tight? Worry, 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 am I kissing her right?
Babe?
She said, no,
the snap you sent me is way cuter than the one on your story. The one on your story is so unexpected. Really funny. I thought it was a goblin.
Oh.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
Did you know at Slocum's Joe you can get a large coffee and a jelly donut for only $30?
$30?
I'm telling the truth. If you don't like jelly, then 50 different flavors to choose from.
I mean, it could definitely be lovely, lovely, sexy alien.
That's right. And it's not some special promotion. The price won't change in a week. Nope. You go today, tomorrow, even next year, and the price will be the same. $30. That's incredible. I think I have $30 just lying around in my couch cushions. And there's no better place to spend it than at Slocum's Joe. The only place to start your morning.
Were you finding new filters?
St. Louis spent the last hour knocking the cover off the thing. And do you know whose fault that is?
I'm afraid I don't, Coach.
Yours, you nincompoop.
I thought you said my name was Skip.
Yes.
Hey, boss.
Hey, you ever wonder where a cup of joe gets their name?
There's actually two theories. It might be a portmanteau.
Gesundheit.
No, that wasn't a sneeze. A portmanteau is a conflation of two words.
Nice.
In this case, Joe is a combination of Java and Mocha.
That makes sense. What's the other theory?
Well, because coffee's for ordinary Joes, it makes sense that that's what they call their favorite beverage. Joe.
But my name's Landon Christofferson. Does that mean I can't enjoy the smooth, great taste of Cup of Joes?
Well, Landon, I have to admit your name is kind of ridiculous. You should really consider changing it. But as long as you were born here in America,
hey, boss,
I don't see a problem with you having a cup.
Oh, good. We don't want some good-for-nothing pinko drinking our coffee anyway.
I think we can all agree on that.
Hey,
Cup
boss,
of Joe really
can we talk
is the all-American Colombian coffee.
Is everything okay?
Yeah, sure, all things considered. Just that whole thing with Colton, it could be a sore spot between us, yeah?
Mm-hmm. What's the matter, Gage? Feeling guilty all of a sudden?
No, ain't no guilt over that call. Look, Colter was a piece of shit.
If you're gonna tell me you shoved a hand up his ass and turned him into a human puppet, I don't wanna hear it.
Damn, woman. Hell of an imagination you got there.
Ew.
Right then, I thought Colton, the gangs would fear and respect, but he was stubborn.
Sure. Oh my God. Put a big, dumb idiot in charge? What could possibly go wrong?
I gave him too much credit. I could admit that. One thing I've learned, whether it's another gang, look, there is always... I don't want that target on me.
Uh-huh.
If I got his ear...
Mm-hmm. You want to get behind me and whisper in my ear? Gage, I didn't know you had it in you.
Come on, boss. I'm being serious here for once. You ain't like Coulter. That's what I'm getting at. You ain't like the other raiders I've run with. So far, you make a pretty damn good overboss. And it's been fun running with you. I'm just saying. I'm starting to be glad we teamed up, is all. All right, fuck it. You know what I'm getting at. Let's get going.
Look alive, Gage.
You need something, boss?
Just wanted to check in.
We're good. We'd be better if we were getting rich and killing.
The police put Pete in jail. Jesse finally met his fate. But when they came to pay his bail, they found him chopping on his cellmate.
Is
it,
what?
Say, turn this record over. You ain't heard nothing yet.
Medicine.
Lemme.
Don't touch that dial. You found the best radio station in Boston. Atomic.
there, from Bristol to Beantown, this is Atomic Radio. Well, hi. I haven't seen you around here before.
That's odd, because I feel like I've been living in this building all my life.
You say it like it's a bad thing. I love this place. The rooms are clean, people are nice. You can't beat that view.
That's because you're new. You love it now, but things change. Love, in particular, has a habit of being fickle.
Sounds like you speak from experience.
Well, not exactly. I'd say most of my experience comes secondhand. Goes part and parcel with the job, really.
You must be a good listener, then. If so many people trust you with their secrets.
Well, it's been around for quite some time, you see. You might even say it's the oldest profession ever known.
Oh? What was it you do for a living?
I hope you're not going to ask me to spell it out for you, because...
No. Just seeing how red your face would get if I said nothing.
That wasn't very nice. So, you don't think any less of me?
Not at all. I happen to be an artist. If anything, you should be thinking less of me.
I love art. What kind do you do?
I'm a painter.
Have I seen any of your work?
Maybe. See that there hardware store across the street? Painted those walls.
Oh, that is indeed quite the masterpiece. A regular Sistine Chapel. And may I ask if a man of your talents would be willing to paint a woman's apartment? Or is that beneath you?
Well, I do have a lot of important clients. But I think I can work it into my schedule. Is this your apartment?
Why? Did you think I was on the clock? Now, whose face is red?
I think you should stop.
Stop what?
Doing what you're doing.
And what? Become a starving artist like you? Besides, I thought you respected what I do. Then tell me, what is this all about?
Well, it's because... I love you. And if you feel the same...
Why does he want to make the gator claw?
It doesn't matter what I feel. Love doesn't pay the bills.
But neither will this. Maybe now, sure, but in 20 years, those men are gonna stop calling.
You sure have a strange way of charming a girl. Telling her she's going to be old and decrepit.
I'm just saying it won't last. Not much in this world ever does. But I'll be here. If you just give me a chance.
Yeah.
You know, when I first moved in here, I was just as wide-eyed as you are now. Every night I'd come out on this balcony and watch the lights go out one by one. Sometimes I'd even bring my guitar and sing the whole city to sleep. But time goes by and that feeling fades. It doesn't matter if you're out here to sing or scream. In the end, you realize no one can hear you either way.
One of them is supposed to be Pan, so the red one is Pan, which is special.
Maybe I'm
and the other one is stuffed.
But the fact that I'm here, listening, it has to mean something too.
I don't know what you want me to say.
Say you love me.
I can't. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I think I might be moving out. No, it's not that. I need to change, is all. Hold on, can I call you later? Yeah, something came up.
What? Oh, why is Nuka World so wacky?
To drift us all.
Oh.
now, a word from our sponsors.
This is a man who smokes Grey Tortoise cigarettes. What kind of a man is he?
I'm the type of man who likes to work on my car. I like to take it apart and put it back together. I get to...
This is Dr. Darren McDermott, last known survivor of the Safari Adventure Replication Facility, continuing my personal recordings. I ventured outside today and almost got spotted by a group of wasteland scavengers that had wandered into Safari Adventure. Therefore, against my own better judgment, I'm going to attempt to splice a few of the more dangerous samples I've left in cold storage. I need to use the Nuka Gen replicator to create some sort of specimen that's formidable, yet trainable. Something that can protect me, but most importantly, protect this facility. It will take some time to work out the chemistry and mathematics of the data, but I'm confident I can create a viable specimen within a few years. I know Dr. Heim would have objected to this course of action, but he isn't here, and I can't let this equipment fall into the wrong hands.
So, like the movie Crawl.
Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing mama, lay that pistol down. Oh, drinking beer in a cabaret, was I having fun? Until one night she caught me right, now I'm on the run.
Oh, lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing mama, lay that pistol down.
She's a terror, make no error, but there ain't no lassie fair. Here's what we tell. Oh, cool. I made myself a virtual boy here. Nice. Kill all the... In the water.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
We all know how much kids and adults alike love the great taste of Nuka-Cola Classic, Nuka Cherry, and Diet Nuke. And now it's our pleasure to announce to you the latest in soda flavor technology. Nuka-Cola Quantum. 17. Yeah. Blend it together with that Nuka-Cola flavor. Nuka-Cola is a perfect stop drink for all occasions. New Strontium Additive has got that unique fresh and radiant. Good job or a night on. Nuka-Cola Quantum. Twice the carbohydrate, twice the caffeine, and twice the taste.
Best in talk, sports, and music. Talk Radio.
Hubris Comics presents the one, the only, the Fantoma! By day, she's a court stenographer, earning a modest living.
Nuka World is proud to be hosting our quantum celebration. Stop by Cappy's Cafe to sample Nuka-Cola's flavor.
Did you hear, Felicia? Someone robbed millionaire Rex Ruthless, disguised as his favorite
prostitute. Shoot the tail.
You think it might be a phantom?
I wouldn't know you. I just belong to the novice. By the way, I thought you'd get for your birthday a gold watch.
Why, thank you. Although I think your engraver got it wrong. He shall say,
of course, but I'm still it stands standing. For Righteous Richter. Richter means judge in German.
I didn't know that. Are your ancestors German?
Sure, whatever. Now, what did the papers say about this phantom?
Well, they say she's a master thief and a skilled impersonator. Some say last night's job was just a
warm-up. Due to a mix-up at Safari Adventures Animal Waste Facility, apple juice will not be served this evening at the Four Leaf Fried Fish Restaurant.
Thank you, Richter. I'll see you tomorrow. That was almost too easy. You'd think the crown jewels would be better guarded.
Oh, but they are, my purple purloiner.
I should have known you'd show up, the dark rodent in the flesh. Or the first
again?
Although I...
We're happy to announce that...
Let me go get a drink.
...card ride has finally reopened with
some
restraints following last year's tragedy.
Can I have a drink?
Oh, right. You know... Falcons technically eat rodents, though. That's a name for you.
I swear that's not why I did it.
Those aren't even words. Actually, it's Spanish for the phantom. Anyways, I'm not arguing with you. You are
Corey. I assume you meant that as well.
Please refrain from making rude gestures.
Wait, do you want me to actually make something, or are you okay with this still?
That's what makes you say that, my villainous person.
Because you're a villain.
I thought it's going to be fun.
Oh, I did. I was amused by it. I was just like, I don't know if you mean a real one, which is pretty funny. I needed one before the fake, the other one anyway. I needed a real drink, quote unquote, before the fake, quote unquote, drink, quote unquote. Period, quote unquote. That's so minor, I wouldn't mind.
And you don't have the authority to arrest me. And if you serve as witness to my trial, I'll have your testimony thrown out on account of it being a loony dressed in a bat suit.
She seems to know a lot about the legal system, Bruce. Do you think she has a job there?
Damn it, Falcon Boy. How many times do I have to tell you not to use my real name?
I'm sorry, Bruce. I mean, the Dark Rodent.
It's all right. Just don't do it again. Now, where was I?
Actually, she escaped while you were yelling at me. Now the cops are on their way. Should we let the commissioner know what happened?
No, it's like she said. We're technically criminals, too. In fact, we'd better get out of here. To the Bat Vertible.
this just the front door? Why am I... Ah.
Shaped like a square, or worse yet, a banana. That would be a cruel joke indeed. And aren't you lucky that yum yum deviled eggs are the same? Perfectly round and contoured. Each egg is hard boiled to perfection and stuffed with generous helpings of mayonnaise, salt, and mustard. From the head to the yum yum dairy cakes, they're kept fresh all the way. So they're grade A all the way. Just look at how happy Mother Hen is to see her children. Seasoned and ready to eat, right out of the box.
Reserve your tickets now and be the first to ride our Angry Anaconda coaster opening soon at Safari Adventure.
We're on there from Bristol to Beantown. This is Atomic Radio.
Due to high demand, we've added a second performance of Queen Quantum's Coronation. Please check your park brochure for details.
Second baseman for the Capitol Congressman, Wayne Terwilliger, is here. Hello, Wayne.
Hello, Frank. Glad to be here.
You've got a good team this year. What do you think your chances for winning the pennant are?
Well, I don't want to brag, but I think we're going to go all the way.
Is that a guarantee?
It most certainly is. You see, I got it all worked out. New York's ahead of us by 2 games right now. And I heard DiMaggio say they were going to take things 1 game at a time. Well, you know how they say we should always give 110%? I figured if we give 440% every time out, we can take things 4 games at a time. That's 3 whole games better than a team from New York.
Is that
attention.
Right?
All contestants for the Nuka-Cola drinking contest must turn in their indemnity waivers before they will be allowed to participate.
The laws of space and time.
No, be because if we did that, we wouldn't gain any ground. It's a pennant race. We have to catch them.
I don't think it's literally a race. They just call it that.
I'm sorry, Frank. That just doesn't make any sense.
Maybe you're right. Well, good luck with the season.
We don't need luck. We have the math in our favor.
If you say so. Either way, that's all the time we have for today. Tune in next week when my guest will be Golden Globe star Cindy Gray. Only on the Atomic Hour.
And now, a word from our sponsor.
Attention. We're happy to announce that Mad Mulligan's Minecart Ride has finally reopened with stronger restraints following last year's tragedy.
Let's go! Go bowling! Whether you're a boy or a girl, a novice or a seasoned pro, nothing beats the excitement of back alley bowling. For the low, low price of $5,000 a game, you and your friends can enjoy America's new pastime. Don't worry, Bobby. That ball may be destined for the gutter, but your social life is anywhere but, now that you've discovered back alley bowling.
And now...
While touring Nuka World, why not try a refreshing Nuka drink? Nuka Orange or Nuka Cherry. Now available at any one of our park concession stands. Parents, if you're looking for a refreshing way to make it through the day, try a Nuka Cola Dark. Same great cola taste with an alcohol twist.
Don't touch that dial. You found the best radio station in Boston. Atomic Radio.
Dumb snake coaster.
You
Dad used to talk about the Dunwich building like it was alive. Not just some building made of iron and steel. It never made a lot of sense. Dad was a practical man. He never had a spiritual bone in his body. But when he spoke about that place, his voice turned low. Some might mistake it for respect, but I knew it was fear. And when he said the building might someday eat him alive, I took him at his word. Ghost stories are nothing new. There's always some tale about a house on a hill, a ghost in the walls, a bump in the night. These stories endure because there are people willing to tell them, spread them from generation to generation like a family heirloom. And while they may seem like ancient folklore, the mere fact that these stories exist...
I changed the color of my light. Red makes it feel like a horror movie.
Because ghost stories don't get told. They die with the screams of the people who live them. So why should you believe me? Maybe because I'm not telling you a story.
Sito never been here.
I'm telling you where to find
it. Sito no like this place. New friend done? No more monsters?
I know they never gonna work right after this.
And they should not be coming back. Your family's safe, Sito.
Sito, so how, Sito?
Mm-hmm. I have some friends moving in here. But if you play it cool, we can all get along. Can you do that?
Sito, trust you. Sito like more new friends. Before go, here, new friend take. It better shiny thing Sito save.
Sito want I don't think so. I think you have to set it up with
you,
the bot.
New friend. Sito always remember you.
Also, you misspelled gamble. That might have... That would have had something to do with it.
Sito.
Oh my god, hon. I'm glad that I added that.
Listen, this one.
Smash Bros. 64. Oh no.
Unforeseen circumstances, the daily duel of Nuka Knight and the Nuka-Cola Dark Knight has been postponed until further notice.
Maybe you'll ask me And now, a word from our sponsors.
And now, for an important public service announcement. It's a question that every mother asks themselves at least once while nursing their child. How soon is too soon? When do I start weaning my child off this bland, unhealthy breast milk and start giving them those sweet essential sugars found in every bottle of Nuka-Cola? Well, the answer is not soon enough. Laboratory tests over the last few years have proven that babies who start drinking soda during that early formative period have a much higher chance of gaining acceptance and fitting in during those awkward preteen and teen years. Start them on a strict regimen of sodas and other sugary carbonated beverages right now for a lifetime of guaranteed happiness. This message is brought to you by the Nuka-Cola Foundation and the Soda Pop Board of America.
Howdy, partners. Welcome to
the best in rock, sports, drama, and
y'all
music.
Are
Atomic
having
Radio.
A good day here at
E-R.
Ready to
everything's just
E-R.
Ride into
there's
the
Duff Diner, right next to the old drugstore. The people are the same, too. There's Bill the barber, Martha the grocer.
Well, howdy there, Sheriff. Looks like you got some pesky varmints here in the gulch that need straightening out.
I don't know about varmints. But we got us some no good outlaws holed up in Mad Mullion's mind. We could sure use a hand. Want to be my deputy?
Time to prepare for your homecoming.
Why? I thought they might like it if I surprised them.
Really, that's
not
a good
making
idea.
Any sense. What is this?
Processing. Confused. Are concerned. Visitor.
Why should I call them first?
No need
what's going
to worry.
On?
I am just a
this?
Friendly Nuka-Cola Protectron. Program 14 part. Amusement. Our friendly cowboy personalities will.
I guess I could bring a little law and order.
The door to my Mulligan's mind is you'll need to prove to them your good luck, little doggy. And don't forget.
What drugs? What institution? I've been in Costa Rica.
Oh, honey, you don't just think my half solution. Nobody has some time. I mean, could you get out of Costa Rica on a map?
Sure. Right next to Arizona.
Don't
call it me a liar. Where's Dad? He'll tell me.
What? You don't remember? You murdered your father right in this very room. And we've been trying to cover it up ever since.
I murdered him.
You're the new deputy.
Is that what caused me to lose my mind?
Well,
well,
I ain't impressed yet. Let's
see
how you
quite well.
Handle an
old-fashioned
quick draw.
What's wrong with that?
The rules
Sam's a good-looking
are
man.
Simple.
Sam's a
we'll
girl.
Each
and
walk into the street.
And she's
I'll
been
count
dead
to
for 7
three.
Years.
Oh, no.
And then I'll say, draw.
Did I kill her?
First one
did that put
to
me
hit
over the edge?
The other
that, or the pills,
wins.
Or that weird cult you joined. Look. The point is, it's really awkward when you come home and I have to explain this to you every
hold
time.
Hold on to your hat, one-eyed Ike, because I'm about to show you the fastest gun in the West.
Let's see if your shooting is as fast as your mouth, partner. Hey, now, we can't have a shootout without all right, gunslinger. Let's take this out to the street. I count to three, then we draw one,
old Pete just
two,
blew in two of his pound and he's
three,
chopping up all
draw.
The women's meat.
You ready to slash iron and two.
But the Pete's got a long, sharp knife. He starts chopping, don't know when to stop. All you
look, I'm in a hurry.
Can we just say I won?
I suppose, considering how crowded the park is, here you are.
Donated to support our men and women fighting overseas.
Oh, thank goodness. Help me corral my missing giddy up buttercups. They're dead giddy.
Attention, parents. We still have 14 unclaimed children recovered from.
Actually, I really don't want to do that.
Well, I suppose there ain't.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
Hi, my name is Bill Sherman, CEO of Prescott Pharmaceuticals. And I'm here to tell you about an exciting new product called Freo. It's a nasal spray that provides immediate relief for hay fever, runny nose, and itchy eyes. Just one squirt of your nose. Far away from pollen, allergies. You'll feel like your sinuses are in a better.
Chopping the ants out of the air. Soda.
Yes.
So, John, got any plans tonight?
None that involve you.
Why not? We could catch a movie.
No offense, but going to the movies with you is like watching paint dry.
That doesn't make any sense. Going to a movie isn't like watching anything but the movie.
It makes perfect sense. I go to a movie, you sit next to me, and now I'm bored.
What if I randomly sat next to you? How would you even know I was there?
How else? Because there'd be paint on the screen. Nothing but drying paint. And as soon as I saw the paint, I say to myself, gee, I bet I know who that is sitting next to me. Why, it's my old pal Jeffrey.
But have you ever seen paint dry? It's not as dull as you think.
Of course it is. It's paint. It dries. End of story.
Well, let me ask you this. Which part dries first? The top or the bottom?
Huh. Now that's a good question. I guess I don't know.
So you admit, it's kind of interesting.
Maybe. What's your point?
My point is, stop being an insufferable arse and let's go watch a movie.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
Oh, dear. How am I going to get this stain out?
It's a problem for every housewife. You just cooked a wonderful roast for your family, and now comes the hard part. Tough, greasy stains on your dish.
$5.
You'll be happy to know that periods aren't just about being good at sports. There's pros and cons, like giving birth.
I'm sorry, Molly. Here I thought it was just rainbows and candy canes. Now I know better.
Don't worry about it. So the next time you see a girl doing something you can't, just remember it's
tours
not you.
Tours for Star Control are now full for the day.
I'll
see you to a park concierge for additional information.
You can just chill and play some Crusader Kings. You could play some of that weird game with me.
I don't want to set the world on fire. Shoes ruined at the Barnyard Animal Petting Zoo? Pick up a new pair at the Dry Rock Gulch gift shop for only $50. A flame in
your heart. In my heart, I have but one.
And that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be
Paris. If you're looking for a refreshing way to move through the day, try a new Cola Dark. Same great cola taste with an alcohol twist. I have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire.
I just want to start a flame in your
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much.
While touring Nuka World, why not try a refreshing Nuka Grape, Nuka Orange, or Nuka Cherry? Now available at any one of our park concession stands.
Drinks?
Way down inside of me, darling, I have only one desire. And that one desire is you. And I know nobody else ain't going.
Attention, space pilots. Earth is under attack, and you could be our only hope for survival. Ships are now boarding at Nuka Galaxy. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same. I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me,
Hey. How you doing, buddy?
Remember to show your park admission.
Never mind, boy.
Get half off an order of Nuka Prize.
I agree, it's the Frostpunk one.
USA.
Howdy.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
It's been said that a dog is man's best friend. Well, let's re-examine that theory, shall we? Does a best friend leave excrement all over your yard or rub his privates on your leg? Does a best friend demand you feed him, walk him, and throw him sticks, when clearly the only one getting anything out of this relationship is him? No, true friendship is mutually beneficial. A real best friend will tell you a joke when you're feeling down, or bake you a cake on your birthday. He doesn't dirty the floors, he sweeps them. And he greets your arrival with a sharp tongue, not a slobbering one. It's time we ask for more from a friendship. General Atomics, Mr. Handy. Man's best friend. Reinvent.
We're on the air from Bristol to Beantown. This is Atomic Radio.
The electromagnetic shielding up? Without it, the machine might malfunction.
It's up. Not that'll help much, given the other dozen or so parts it could fail in its place.
Dr. Sanders, I get the distinct feeling you don't share my enthusiasm for this project.
Dr. Jones, I'd like to think of the 20 years we've been together, I've given you a lot. I've given you my time, my sweat, cheese. I even gave you my secret recipe for banana bread. Not that you'd know how to use it, but the one thing I won't give you is my enthusiasm. Not when you choose to risk your life for this experiment.
You're so fucking
risk
dead.
Is a part of
Don't
life,
worry.
Doctor.
I'll
you take a risk
it.
When you eat your sugar bombs in the morning, when you drive your Corvega, and when you cheat on your husband. Every second is a dice roll. The only saving grace is some semblance of control. But when it comes to nuclear war, to radioactive fallout, and the end of days, you have no choice.
You better finish that, dude.
In the hands of two men with their fingers on the button. And you know there's only a matter of time before one of them pushes it. That's why we built our own machine.
Limited tickets for 5 p.m. are still available.
Time, and when you press it, nothing will ever be the same.
Too strong.
Yeah, I guess the rain coming up.
Nuka World, great Halloween spooktacular will begin next week. Reserve your tickets for this nighttime event at the main box office.
All right, Dr. Jones, you have my attention. What is this urgent message you wish to relay?
Mr. President, I want you to take your finger off the button.
I'm sorry, but what button?
You know which one. The one you use in the event of an invasion. The button that fires the nukes.
Dr. Jones, you do realize there isn't an actual button, right?
What do you mean?
Dr. Jones, there's no big red button to fire a nuclear arsenal. The generals, they make a recommendation. Then I give the authorization to launch.
You're wrong, Mr. President. I'm positive there's a button somewhere. And with the way things are going, it's only a matter of time before you push it. I know these things because, well, go ahead and ask me how I know.
All right. I'm gonna indulge you. How do you know?
Because I'm a time traveler.
Dr. Jones, that is quite frankly the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard.
And yet it's the truth. Listen to me, Mr. President. Do not press the button.
I think I've heard quite enough. I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
I think you'll remember. I think we'll...
So, how did it go?
I couldn't change a thing. I went to a dozen critical points in history, as far back as the invention of the button itself, and I couldn't convince a single person I was a time traveler. Not even your husband.
Well... You can hardly... Wait, what?
You think after I told him about the affairs and the drugs, he would... Well, it doesn't matter. I'm beginning to think the past can't be changed, which means we have no choice but to accept this future.
So? What do we do now?
All we can do is hope. If the president doesn't know where the button is, it's possible he'll never get the chance to press it.
Other side's chained up.
Dr. Sanders, it's humanity's greatest weakness... And it's saving grace.
I would make a note on my phone. Game just locked up. How did I fix it? Oh no, the controller died. That's okay too, I guess. I need to find some batteries. Some double A's. Okay, the whole game is weirdly locked up. The controller did die, but I can't move it at all anymore. Let's just restart that. Super weird. Alright, I was hanging out in some beans. Oh, this is the one that locked up the game. Let's try again.
Nice.
Not worth it. Bingo, bango, bungle, I'm so happy in the jungle, I refuse to go. Don't want no bright lights, false teeth, doorbells, landlords, I make it clear. Oh, where did I get hit from? You. That cow explode. Oh, that's so funny. Can I pick that up?
Now, a word from our sponsors.
Jangles! I can't seem to find the sugar bombs! What do you mean we're all out? We packed over 40 boxes! boxes for this trip. How in Ursa Major am I going to stop the Zetachronian invasion on an empty stomach? Jangles, open out on me. You stupid primate. Bananas are for monkeys. But the mobs are for kids.
That's right. Not even a smart monkey like Jangles can resist the sweet, explosive taste of Sugar Bomb. So why should you? Sugar Bomb! The supernova of cereals!
The best in talk, sports, drama, and music. Atomic Radio.
In the shadowy forests of Raynard lives a formidable adversary who fights with a quick wit and a sleight of hand. In all the world, only one man can be considered his better. Grognak the Barbarian. Watch him match wit with a diabolical trickster in this tale of sharp minds and sharper swords.
You fell into my trap again, hey. Grognak. And only by solving my riddles will you save yourself from death.
Grognak has no time to play your little boy games, trickster!
Foolish barbarian, still using every muscle except the one that counts.
And what muscle would that be?
What do you think, you mindless ape? The brain!
Thump.
Shows what you know. Grognak does not use his brain to count. He uses his fingers. The same fingers he will use to break your neck!
It was everything you promised, Sheriff. More fun than a bale full of hay.
Well, all right. Please put in a good word with Nuka-Cola. Corporate, when your survey card arrives in the mail, here, take some souvenir bottle caps courtesy of the Nuka-Cola. Janitorial Service Department. You and your friends are...
Look at how Jim here spreads a generous portion over his frankfurter. This is his third helping, and he's yet to reach for that antacid bottle. Despite having stomach problems, there's no fear of the runs here. Not with Blamco flowing through his colon. And believe me when I say, it tastes even better than it sounds. Mac and cheese, the light, tasty dinner in a box, made by Blamco.
And now, some meat.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart, I have but one desire. And that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just...
Thanks to the hard work of our kick-ass overboss, I'm happy to report that the Safari Zone is no longer a death trap. All those crazy-ass mutated animals have been taken care of. The overboss has left the pack in charge out there. They're probably thrilled to have their own cages now. Overboss is on a roll now, right? Another zone is all ours. Y'all ever feel like you just can't get enough? Yeah. Well, Red Eye Fish, he knows what it's like.
Well, I've been told it's in our blood, under our skin and all that, but doesn't matter if I'm buried in stuff. I just can't ever get enough. I need one last score. I could be sitting on a throne of caps and still need one last score. It ain't about the haul, could just be scraps. Well, I've seen guys lose their mind just trying to hold onto too much trash. They're convinced it's gold, but I can help
them out by lacking in their stash. If you've lost your hidden cash allowances, additional pairs can be purchased from any souvenir stand in any of our cars.
I can clear out a whole damn town and still need one last score. Take anything that ain't nailed down. It ain't really a foul. It's more than stuff I steal. It's more about this notion, this grand ideal, that I could take whatever, whoever, whenever I please. But sometimes this starts to feel like a disease, cause I can't control it, like an itch that I can't scratch. All that I can do is just add to my stash. I know it won't cure me, but what else can I do? I ain't got anything else to turn to. I need one last score. Need I make this go away? Just one more score, and I can maybe rest easy someday.
Corporation.
Who wants some good news? You? Is it you? Because I got some. I say Kitty Kingdom, and you immediately think what? Ghouls, right? Well, think again, halfwits. Not only did the overboss wade in there and wipe them out, she was nice enough to take the one ghoul left with half a brain and give him a freaking job. Believe that?
Attention guests.
The disciples are now kings, or I guess queens
of the castle. Antivenom is available
at the exit
for the reptile house.
Lot play nice. I ever tell you all about the time I got my hand?
One time, a long time ago, I'm enjoying myself, you know, out in the combat zone. A few bets, a few drinks, a whole lot of jokes. I'm making friends, having a good time. Now this one guy, he gets jealous. Can't blame him, it happens to me all the time. People just get upset that they ain't as cool. Anyway, he's this really big guy, I mean huge guy actually. I don't remember his name, doesn't matter, shut up. So this big idiot decides he's gonna challenge me to a drinking contest. Guess he figures he'll make me look like a fool in front of all the nice folks at the combat zone. So he lumbers up to me, comes up to my table, tells me he can drink me under the table. I'm like, the hell you can, try me. So everybody gathers round because it's clear this is gonna be the coolest thing that happens all night. We just go at it, just shot after shot after shot. Now the whole time he's talking shit about me. Telling me I'm gonna lose, telling me that I'm a piece of shit, you know, all this stuff, and I'm just laughing. I'm laughing, I'm taking my shots. I'm so drunk, and I mean so drunk, that it's crazy. Later on, people were like, man, you were so amazing, I didn't even know how you could still be standing. I've never seen anyone drink that much. After a while, you know, I see that big guy start to get wobbly, right? It's not gonna last much longer, but you know, I need a minute to make sure that I'm not so drunk that I'm just seeing him. But I'm right, it's him. He is wobbly. So I push through it, man. I knock him down, and I keep taking shots. Finally, he just goes face first into the table, out cold. No question.
Over here.
And I'm so pumped up, I picked this guy up. I shit you not, I picked him right up, totally raged out. And then I just, bam, slam him back down onto the floor. And I'm screaming, yeah, man, yeah, who's the best, who's the best? And this one guy, he comes over, he looks at me, and he's like, oh, man, you blew all the blood vessels in your eye, man. That's totally messed up. That's so cool. And then everyone cheers even more. And I was so pumped up, I didn't even feel it. And everyone's all like, yeah, let's hear it for Red Eye.
Oh, it was pretty great. You should have been there.
On the back is no. Damn it, Mason, I told you I am.
That's
not
creepy. I don't like it.
Ever. So I was thinking about the time I came to the room. I ever tell you that into that story? Doesn't matter. I feel like telling it now. Shut up.
So, like a year ago, I'm running with this gang. Pretty good deal. I mean, I probably could have been in charge, you know, but whatever. I don't need that kind of hassle, right? I mean, I'm totally capable of running my own gang. Probably the best friggin' gang you've ever seen. But anyway, I hear this dude, Coulter, is putting together a huge-ass team of raiders to take over Nuka World. And I hear this, and I just gotta go check it out. You know, see if it's the real deal. Now, the guys I'm running with, they're all upset that I'm leaving. They're so upset, they just keep saying, oh, come on, man, you have to stay. You're the best out of all of us. We're screwed without you. But I'm like, no, man, I ain't gonna let you guys hold me back. So I go out on my own. I travel through some crazy shit you wouldn't believe even if I told you about it. And I wind up here. Now, I find out who Coulter is, and I just march right up to his face and say, well, here I am. Now what? You can see right away that he was impressed. You know, he looks at me and he says, man, you look like hell. How long has it been since you slept? And I say, well, I don't know, man. Doesn't matter. I can sleep when I'm dead. And you can see on his face that he was totally impressed. Just like he knew I was the real deal. So first he says, man, I am impressed. You're the real deal, Red Eye. I'm gonna call you that because your eyes are bloodshot as hell and it looks really cool. He says, you're gonna be my right-hand man because I can tell just by looking at you that I can count on you. But then, like, he stops and he sees the guitar I'm carrying and he says, oh, no shit, you can play? And I look at him and I say, I don't know, man, can I? Yeah, Coulter, like you said, I am the real deal. And he loses his mind. You know, he's so excited. He says, oh, no way. I got an even more important job for you.
Yes.
Get your ass into that radio station and make it amazing. Well, and here we are. Swear to you, true story. All of it, every word. Of course, Coulter ended up being kind of a chump, but I mean, you know, I knew that from the beginning. Like, I probably could have challenged him right there. You know, made myself the overboss, but, you know, whatever. I like this gig just fine. Yeah.
It's Red Eye here, running Raider Radio. You love it, and you know it. I hear Dixie is looking for volunteers for target practice, and I quote, fun will be had by all. I'd think twice before raising my hand for that one. Here's a little something which I know you've all heard pieces of before, only this time you've got Red Eye, the master of storytelling, to lay it on you.
Now this here is a true story. And I know it's a true story, because I heard like
10 different versions from 10 different guys, all of them swearing it's true. And when you get a story like that, well, you just know there's got to be some truth to it. Well, the way this story starts is a mystery. Nobody knows where the legendary raider named Atlas came from. Some say he was in the Great War, got hit right smack in the face with one of them big nukes, shrugged it off, and kept on going. Some say he just appeared out of thin air, like the wastes themselves conjuring him up. Some say he was the product of a night of passion between a super mutant, a Deathclaw, and Satan himself. Now, most of you all know the later stories, how Atlas single-handedly took down that band of super mutants south of Boston. I heard he bit the head off the leader's dog. The head, clean off. Or that time he took a group of five men, only five, downtown straight into a rival gang's territory and walked out with their leader's son just because the kid said some mean things about Atlas's mother. But the biggest story was that spot way north of Boston. What the hell was the name of it again? Doesn't matter, I guess, because it ain't there no more. Andover, I think that was it. Somewhere up there. Anyway, this little shithole of a town was home to the Junkers, a gang that by most rights never should have lasted more than, like, a week. I don't know how they made it, but they survived. They got by. Somehow they got noticed. In particular, Atlas noticed the gang leader's woman, a blonde number named Hope. Atlas, they say, was smitten in love from the moment he arrived. Hope, though, well, she didn't do it.
Hey, asshole! You're listening to Raider Radio. Nisha has asked that I pass this along. Max,
attention, please.
Steal from us
today's
again.
Today's performance of Capio and Bottlehead will begin in approximately 15 minutes.
Thanks. Sounds personal.
Come on. So, I told you about Atlas, the meanest raider to ever wander this world, and how he fell for Hope, a beautiful raider from a rival gang that didn't give two shits about him. Now, like I said, Atlas, he was used to getting his way.
Attention,
so he gathered up a big old army of raiders, marched right up to the town where Hope's gang, the Junkers, was all holed up, and demanded she come out and talk to him. Hope, headstrong as she was, very politely yelled over the wall and told Atlas exactly where he could shove his intentions. I hear she launched that golden Brahmin right back over the wall at him, too. Atlas, as you might imagine, didn't take too kindly to being disrespected. But in his own special crazy-ass way, he found himself wanting Hope even more. He was in a bind now, you see. He couldn't let her insults stand, but he wasn't ready to just up and storm the town and risk killing Hope in the process. In my opinion, folks, ain't no relationship worth this kind of trouble. I'm just being honest with you. Anyway, so Atlas calls out a few of his lieutenants, talks to them all quiet for a few minutes. Then these poor saps march right out in front of the wall surrounding the town, and I swear to you, they set themselves on fire right then and there. Over the screaming, Atlas yells
attention.
That if he can convince these
We're
good men to set fire
that.
To themselves, imagine what he can convince the other couple hundred men to do to their town. Personally, I find that a pretty convincing argument. But Hope, she ain't backing down. She yells that Atlas can set himself on fire. That'd get him about as far as anything. Now I tell you, when Atlas hears this, he gets angry beyond all reason. And he slams those giant fists down on the ground. As the door goes, windows shatter in Diamond City. And a whole section of Lexi crashing down just from shock. Hope and her gang wake up the next morning and find their town. Still standing as far as the eye can see. Atlas says it's the last threat he's gonna make before he storms their gates.
Yeah!
Between us, Hope is way off the rails. Now Hope, she's a good woman.
a raider through and through. But she takes care of her own. She knows there ain't no way her little gang can stand up to Atlas and his army. And so she knows what she's gotta do. White flag goes up, and Hope herself walks right out the front gate. Says if Atlas gives his word that her gang is safe, she'll go free. Only, he's got a shake on it. Atlas, proud man that he is, takes her up on that offer. And it's not until he's shaking her hand that he hears the beeping.
Bless you, boy.
Hope went and strapped herself up with more than a couple of mini nukes. She knew what she was about. Now, I am told that on that day, the sun might as well not even have come up. For all the good it did next to the brightness of that explosion. Men hundreds of miles away went blind. Birds dropped out of the sky for days after. And for as big and as tough as he was, they ain't never found all of Atlas. Like I said at the top, true story. All of it. Is there a moral in all of this? Hell if I know.
Hostile target
detected. It's Red Eye here, running the Raider Radio. You love it, and you know it.
No better. I can do this all day.
The operators would like me to announce that they're hosting a free dinner for all gang members interested in... No, they're trying to poison you. Don't go to that. This next one, I've been hearing some shit that I ripped this off or whatever. That's bullshit, man. It ain't true. I wrote this. I swear it. A Red Eye original, you could say. Hey there, fella, what you doing out here all alone? Hasn't anybody told you you're better off staying home? See, these roads ain't safe at night, especially out here on your own. Might run into someone like me, get yourself knocked upside the dome. Give me what you got, I'm only gonna count to 10. Give me what you got, I won't say it again, punk. I'm the one with the gun, so I'll tell you when you're done. Now give me what you got, and you might just walk away. Say the pretty lady, looking mighty fine tonight. I'm afraid I'm gonna need all your caps. Don't think about putting up a fight. Didn't anybody tell you that raiders run this town? Too late now, shut that little mouth. I got no problem putting you down. Give me what you got, I'm only gonna count to 10. Give me what you got, I won't
stop. My God. Give me what you got. Why? I have one, I'm good. Oh, goodness. I'm tearing.
Don't hold nothing back. Arguing will get you killed, so don't give me no flack. I see suckers every day that they think they can take me on. Well, you'll see that I'm still here, and they're all gone. Give me what you got. I changed my mind, I'll count to 3. Give me what you got. You listening to me?
Give me what you got. Ain't no chance you're gonna walk away. Yeah, man. Yeah, hell yeah. You don't have to come up to me and say, man, Red Eye, that was so good. Man, I love that. I already know it's good. I don't need your approval. You're all a bunch of psychopaths, and I love you for it. This is Raider Radio, and it's for you. I have a note here from Mags to Mason. flaming bags of shit. That the best you can do? Okay, I'm sorry, but that's funny. Stupid as hell, but funny. This one ain't about me. It's about this friend that I have, who is not me.
First time I ever seen you was down at the beach by a Revere. Through a thick black haze of fire and smoke, things suddenly seemed so clear. I knew I had to have you, make you mine at any cost. I gave up on my old crew, never worried about what I'd lost. I gave you gold, I gave you caps, gave you all I'd stolen more. Never counted on you stealing from me and running out the door. Baby, quit raiding my heart. You took all I had and left me. I can't stand being apart. This ain't no way to try and test me. I know you remember all the fun we had playing the odds at Easy City. And when we roasted that caravan down in the fens, I was so happy to have you with me. But after a while, I couldn't keep denying what I daily witnessed. The caps, the guns, the blood-soaked ground, well, I just couldn't hold your interest. Now I don't buy what they tell me, that you can't ever be satisfied. I'll kill every last man in the whole wide world just to have you by my side. Baby, quit raiding my heart. Bring back the love you stole. I can't stand being apart. I need you here to make me whole.
Yes.
Poor Fabor. Love hurts. It really does. I mean, that's what my friend said when he told me the story, and then I went and wrote a song about it. Whatever. Hey, hey! Got some news for you all. Word's getting around that the overboss has been seen meeting up with the head honchos for each of the gangs. No one's told me shit yet, but doesn't take a genius to figure out what's going on. That's right, we're taking the park. The whole damn thing. Don't shake your head at me. I'm telling you, that's what's going down. You just wait. This new overboss is the real deal, man. Getting shit done. You're all a bunch of psychopaths. And I love you for it. This is Raider Radio, and it's for you. Listen up, all you junkies, lowlives, and all-around assholes. We've got a reason to celebrate. In case you haven't heard, the overboss has cleared out Dry Rock Gulch, and it's all ours. By the overboss's decree, the disciples are now in charge out there. So, if you're on their bad side, you might want to think twice before heading in there to check it out. Add another one to the tally, deadbeats. The overboss is getting shit done. Y'all ever feel like you just can't get enough? Well, Red Eye hears you, man. He knows what it's like.
Well, I've been told it's in our blood, under our skin and all that mud. Doesn't matter if I'm buried in stuff. I just can't ever get enough. I need one last score. I could be sitting on a throne of caps and still need one last score. It ain't about the haul, could just be scraps. Well, I've seen guys lose their mind just trying to hold onto too much trash. They're convinced it's gold, but I can help them out by lighting in their stash. Just by being a good neighbor and pulling in that cash. I need one last score. I can clear out a whole damn town and still need one last score. Take anything that ain't nailed down.
See, it ain't really about all the stuff I steal. It's more about this notion, this grand ideal, that I could take whatever, whoever, whenever I please. But sometimes this starts to feel like a disease, cause I can't control it, like an itch that I can't scratch. All that I can do is just add to my stash. I know it won't cure me, but what else can I do? I ain't got anything else to turn to. I need one last score. Maybe that'll make this go away. Just one more score, and I can maybe rest easy someday.
You're all a bunch of psychopaths, and I love you for it. This is Raider Radio, and it's for you. Listen up, all you disciples, operators, pack, guys, and whoever the hell else is out there these days. Thanks to the hard work of our kick-ass overboss, I'm happy to report that the Safari Zone is no longer a death trap. All those crazy-ass mutated animals have been taken care of. The overboss has left the pack in charge out there. They're probably thrilled to have their own cages now. The overboss is on a roll now, right? Another zone is all ours. I ever tell you all about the time I got my name?
So this one time, a long time ago, I'm enjoying myself, you know, out in the combat zone. A few bets, a few drinks, a whole lot of jokes. I'm making friends, having a good time. Now this one guy, he gets jealous. I mean, I can't blame him. It happens to me all the time. People just get upset that they ain't as cool. Anyway, he's this really big guy. I mean, huge guy, actually. I don't remember his name. Doesn't matter. Shut up. So this big idiot decides he's going to challenge me to a drinking contest. Guess he figures he'll make me look like a fool in front of all the nice folks at the combat zone. So he lumbers up to me, comes up to my table, tells me he can drink me under the table. I'm like, the hell you can, try me. So everybody gathers round because it's clear this is gonna be the coolest thing that happens all night. And we just go at it, just shot after shot after shot. Now, the whole time, he's talking shit about me. I mean, telling me I'm gonna lose, telling me that I'm a piece of shit, you know, all this stuff, and I'm just laughing. I'm laughing, I'm taking my shots. Now, I'm so drunk, and I mean so drunk, that it's crazy. Later on, people were like, man, you were so amazing. I didn't even know how you could still be standing. I've never seen anyone drink that much. And after a while, you know, I see that big guy starting to get wobbly, right? Like he's not gonna last much longer. But you know, I take a minute to make sure that I'm not so drunk that I'm just seeing shit. But I'm right, it's him. He is wobbly. So, you know, I push through it, man. I knuckle down and I keep taking shots. Finally, he just goes face first into the table, out cold, no question. And I'm so pumped up, I pick this guy up. I shit you not, I picked him right up, totally raged out, and then I just, bam, slam him back down onto the floor. And I'm screaming, yeah, man, yeah, who's the best, who's the best? And this one guy, he comes over, he looks at me, he's like, oh, man, you blew all the blood vessels in your eye, man. That's totally messed up. That's so cool. And then everyone cheers even more, and I was so pumped up, I didn't even feel it. And everyone's all like, yeah, let's hear it for Red Eye. Oh, it was pretty great. You should have been there.
Parents, don't forget to pick up your child's Nuka Sheriff Star.
You're all a bunch of psychopaths, and I love you for it. This is Raider Radio, and it's for you. Listen up, all you junkies, lowlives, and all-around assholes. We've got a reason to celebrate. In case you haven't heard, the overboss has cleared out Dry Rock Gulch, and it's all ours. By the overboss's decree, the disciples are now in charge out there. So, if you're on their bad side, you might want to think twice before heading in there to check it out. You rejects understand what this means? Nuka World is ours, man. The whole
friggin' park. So, I was thinking about the time I came to Nuka World. I ever tell you deadbeats that story? Doesn't matter. I feel like telling it now. Shut up. So, like a year ago, I'm running with this gang. Pretty good deal. I mean, I probably could have been in charge, you know, but whatever. I don't need that kind of hassle, right? I mean, I'm totally capable of running my own gang. Probably the best friggin' gang you've ever seen. But anyway, I hear this dude, Coulter, is putting together a huge-ass team of raiders to take over Nuka World. And I hear this, and I just gotta go check it out. You know, see if it's the real deal.
Thank you.
Now, the guys I'm running with, they're all upset that I'm leaving. They're so upset, they just keep saying, "Oh, come on, man, you have to stay. You're the best out of all of us. We're screwed without you." But I'm like, "No, man, I ain't gonna let you guys hold me back." So I go out on my own. I travel through some crazy shit you wouldn't believe even if I told you about it. And I wind up here. Now, I find out who Coulter is, and I just march right up to his face and say, "Well, here I am. Now what?" And you can see right away that he was impressed. You know, he looks at me and he says, "Man, you look like hell. How long has it been since you slept?" And I say, "Well, I don't know, man. Doesn't matter. I can sleep when I'm dead."
Hey.
You
What's
can
up,
see
Bob?
On his face that Alive, he was Gage. Totally
well, I'll
impressed.
Be damned.
Just
you
like
actually did
he
it.
Knew I
Nuka
was the
world
real
is ours.
Deal.
All of it.
So first he says, "Man, I am impressed. You're the real deal, Red
you
Eye.
You expected otherwise?
I'm gonna call you that because
hey,
your eyes are bloodshot
show a little
as
respect.
Hell, and it
Sorry,
looks really
boss.
Cool.
You've just got to understand. We ain't
right
ever been on ground this solid before. Now that we're here,
that
I'm thinking it's time we set up.
Sure.
He stops. Sees the guitar
aiming pretty
says,
high,
no,
aren't you, Gage?
No, shit.
Why stop there?
Wait.
Why not take over the moon
say,
while we're at it?
Oh, man,
nah, the little green. Taking back Nuka World is a big friggin' deal.
Yeah,
these
Coulter,
bunches
like you said,
in operation
I
this
right.
Commonwealth
has... deal. And he loses his mind. You know, he's so excited. He says, "Oh, no way. I got
wow,
an even
nuts.
More important
I was
job
just starting
you.
To get cozy in my little castle.
Now you're starting to sound like Coulter. You remember,
and
he was always content. We don't got
it.
If we're aiming to grab
story,
a piece of the...
Of it,
I say we go have ourselves
course,
a chat
and
shank.
Kind of a chump,
he floated this
you know,
idea before. He's in
like,
charge of the character.
I could have challenged him right there. You know, made myself the overboss, but, you know, whatever. I like this gig just fine.
What's he gonna do? Yeah. Show him how to milk a Brahmin?
Maybe, if you ask him. Just head over and talk to the guy.
Uh-huh.
And while you're doing that, I've already got the
hey,
gang
hey,
working on getting... It's about
you,
time
all.
We shed some real light around
Word's
here. Oh,
around that the
and if you need my advice...
...meeting up with the head honchos for each of the gangs. No one's told me shit yet, but doesn't take a genius to figure out what's going on. That's right, we're taking the park. The whole damn thing. Don't shake your head at me. I'm telling you, that's what's going down. You just wait. This new overboss is the real deal, man. Getting shit done. Hey, asshole. You're listening to Raider Radio. Listen up, all you disciples, operators, pack, guys, and whoever the hell else is out there these days. Thanks to the hard work of our kick-ass overboss, I'm happy to report that the Safari Zone is no longer a death trap. All those crazy-ass mutated animals have been taken care of. The overboss has left the pack in charge out there. They're probably thrilled to have their own cages now. If you've been keeping score at home, you know what this means. The whole goddamn park is ours. Yeah! Here's a little something which I know you've all heard pieces of before, only this time you've got Red Eye, the master of storytelling, to lay it on you. Now this here is a true story. And I know it's a true story, because I heard like 10 different versions from 10 different guys, all of them swearing it's true. And when you get a story like that, well, you just know there's got to be some truth to it. Well, the way this story starts is a mystery. Nobody knows where the legendary raider named Atlas came from. Some say he was in the Great War, got hit right smack in the face with one of them big nukes, shrugged it off, and kept on going. Some say he just appeared out of thin air.
like the wastes themselves conjuring him up. And some say he was the product of a night of unholy passion between a super mutant, a death claw, and Satan himself. Now, most of you all know the later stories, how Atlas single-handedly took down that band of super mutants south of Boston. I heard he bit the head off the leader's dog. The head, clean off. Or that time he took a group of five men, only five, downtown straight into a rival gang's territory and walked out with their leader's son just because the kid said some mean things about Atlas's mother. But the biggest story was that spot way north of Boston. What the hell was the name of it again? Doesn't matter, I guess, because it ain't there no more. Andover, I think that was it. Somewhere up there. Anyway, this little shithole of a town was home to the Junkers, a gang that by most rights never should have lasted more than, like, a week. I don't know how they made it, but they survived. They got by. Somehow they got noticed. In particular, Atlas noticed the gang leader's woman, a blonde number named Hope. Atlas, they say,
hola, lazy boy.
In love,
hola.
The moment he laid eyes on her.
Hello. Hope, though, hey, girlie.
She didn't feel the same.
ELC.
Ladies and gentlemen, there can be no more doubt. If you had any questions, you can now rest assured that our overboss is a badass. I don't know what the overboss has planned next, but man, get behind her or get the hell out of her way. You're all a bunch of psychopaths, and I love you for it. This is Raider Radio, and it's for you.
Hey.
Need something from me?
Hey, anybody listening?
Yeah.
Got some good news for you. All those damn robots in the Galactic Zone, no longer a problem.
Is everything okay between us?
We're good.
We'd be better if we were decided to leave the Galactic Zone in the hands of the operators.
Heads up. Maybe with hey, got any gear for sale?
Yeah, boss. Here's everything I got.
And if it's ours, do you all realize what this means? Nuka World. It all belongs to us. All of it. Hell yeah, man.
So,
more than happy
I told
to hold
you about
all
Atlas,
the expensive stuff.
Meanest raider to ever wander this world.
I'm gonna take my
now
gun back, okay,
Hope,
man?
A beautiful raider from a rival
sorry about that.
Didn't give two shits about him. Now, like I said, Atlas, he was used to getting his way. So we gathered up a big old army of raiders, marched right
damn
up to the town where Hope's gang, the Junkers, was all holed up, and demanded she come out and talk to him. Hope, headstrong as she was, very politely yelled over the wall and told Atlas exactly where he could shove his intentions. I hear
oh yeah, let me go claim my halls and see what those are.
Atlas, as you might imagine, didn't take too kindly to
can't imagine
but in his own
what I got.
Crazy ass way, he found himself wanting Hope even more. He was in a bind now, you see. He couldn't let her insults stand, but he wasn't ready to just up and storm the town and risk killing Hope in the process. In my opinion, folks, ain't no relationship worth this kind of trouble. I'm just being honest with you. Anyway, so Atlas calls out a few of his lieutenants, talks to them all quiet for a few minutes, then these poor saps march right out in front of the wall surrounding the town, and I swear to you, they set themselves on fire right then and there. Over the screaming, Atlas yells that if he can convince these good men to set fire to themselves, imagine what he can convince the other
16 bottle caps.
Personally, I'd find that a pretty amazing argument. But Hope,
you guys have not been doing helpful to me.
Can set himself on fire.
Any day.
That'd get him about as far as anything.
Hey.
Now it's just a matter
you,
of time.
Atlas hears this, he gets angry beyond all reason, and he slams those giant fists down on the ground. As the story goes, windows shattered in Diamond City, and a whole section of Lexington comes crashing down just from the shock of it. Hope and her gang wake up the next morning and find their town the only thing still standing as far as the eye can see. Atlas says
don't
the last threat he's gonna make before he storms their gates. And honestly, between us, this whole thing has already gone way off the rails. Now, Hope, she's a good woman, a raider through and through. But she takes care of her own. She knows there ain't no way her little gang can stand up to Atlas and his army. And so she knows what she's got to do. The white flag goes up, and Hope herself walks right out the front gate. Says if Atlas gives his word that her gang is safe, she'll go free. Only, he's got a shake on it.
What's going on here? Who is he fighting? Who's Maddox? Why are they fighting?
Her hand that he hears the beeping. Clever woman that she was, Hope went and strapped herself up with more than a couple of mini nukes. She knew what she was about.
Hey there.
Now, come on, you know our side had the most fun.
The sun might as well not even have come up. For all the good it did next to the brightness of that explosion. Men.
I have no idea what happened here, so I'm going to reload my save. I literally just went to the market and everyone turned on me. It was weird.
They got by, and somehow they got noticed. In particular, Atlas noticed the gang leader's woman, a blonde number named Hope. Atlas, they say, was smitten in love from the moment he laid eyes on her. Hope, though, well, she didn't feel the same.
Ladies and gentlemen, there can be no more doubt. If you had any questions, you can now rest assured that our overboss is a badass. I don't know what the overboss has planned next, but man, get behind her. You're all a bunch of psychopaths, and I love you for it. This is Raider Radio, and it's for you. Listen up, all you junkies, lowlives, and all-around assholes. We've got a reason to celebrate. In case you haven't heard, the overboss has cleared out Dry Rock Gulch, and it's all ours. By the overboss's decree, the disciples are now in charge out there. So, if you're on their bad side, you might want to think twice before heading in there to check it out. You rejects understand what this means.
Yeah, I'm here to trade, but I'm not letting my guard down.
The Nuka world is ours, man. The whole friggin' park.
So, I told you about Atlas, the meanest raider to ever wander this world, and how he fell for Hope, a beautiful raider from a rival gang.
You see that crazy robot
shit slot him. Now, like I said, Atlas, he was used to getting his way. So he gathered up a big old army of raiders, marched right up to the town where Hope's gang, the Junkers, was all holed up, and demanded she come out and talk to him. Hope, headstrong as she was, very politely yelled over the wall and told Atlas exactly where he could shove his intentions. I hear she launched that golden Brahmin right back over the wall at him too. Atlas, as you might imagine, didn't take too kindly to being disrespected, but in his own special crazy-ass way, he found himself wanting Hope even more. He was in a bind now, you see. He couldn't let her insults stand, but he wasn't ready to just up and storm the town and risk killing Hope in the process. In my opinion, folks, ain't no relationship worth this kind
of thing. How you doing, cutie?
I'm just being honest with you.
Anyway,
so Atlas calls out a few of his lieutenants, talks to them all quiet for a few minutes. Then these poor saps march right out in front of the wall surrounding the town, and I swear to you, they set themselves on fire right then and there. Over the screaming, Atlas yells that if he can convince these good men to set fire to themselves, imagine what he can convince the other couple hundred men to do to their town. Personally, I'd find that a pretty convincing argument. But Hope, she ain't backing down. She yells that Atlas can set himself on fire. That'd get him about as far as anything. Now I tell you, when Atlas hears this, he gets angry beyond all reason.
You know,
and he slams those giant fists down on the ground. As the story goes, windows shattered in Diamond City. And a whole section of Lexington comes crashing down just from the shock of it. Hope and her gang wake up the next morning and find their town the only thing still standing as far as the eye can see. Atlas says it's the last threat he's gonna make before he storms their gates. And honestly, between us, this whole thing has already gone way off the rails. Now Hope, she's a good woman, a raider through and through, but she takes care of her own. She knows there ain't no way her little gang can stand up to Atlas and his army. And so she knows what she's gotta do. The white flag goes up, and Hope herself walks right out the front gate. Says if Atlas gives his word that her gang is safe, she'll go free. Only, he's got a shake on it. Atlas, proud man that he is, takes her up on that offer. And it's not until he's shaking her hand that he hears the beeping. Clever woman that she was, Hope went and strapped herself up with more than a couple of mini nukes. She knew what she was about. Now, I am told that on that day, the sun might as well not even have come up. For all the good it did next to the brightness of that explosion, men hundreds of miles away went blind. Birds dropped out of the sky for days after. Tough as he was, they ain't never found all of Atlas. Like I said at the top, true story. All of it. Is there a moral in all of this? Hell if I know.
You're all a bunch of psychopaths! And I love you for it! This is Raider Radio, and it's for you.
With a quality weapon right here.
Listen up, all you junkies, lowlives, and all-around assholes. We've got a reason to celebrate. In case you haven't heard, the Overboss has cleared out Dry Rock Gulch, and it's all ours. By the Overboss's decree, the Disciples are now in charge out there. So, if you're on their bad side, you might want to think twice before heading in there to check it out. You rejects understand what this means? Nuka World is ours, man. The whole friggin' park. This next one, I've been hearing some shit that I ripped this off or whatever. That's bullshit, man. It ain't true. I wrote this. I swear it. Red Eye original, you could say. Hey there, fella, what you doing out here all alone? Hasn't anybody told you you're better off staying home? See, these roads ain't safe at night, especially out here on your own. Might run into someone like me, get yourself knocked upside the dome. Give me what you got, I'm only gonna count to 10. Give me what you got, I won't say it again. Punk, I'm the one with the gun, so I'll tell you when you're done. Now give me what you got, and you might just walk away. Say the pretty lady, looking mighty fine tonight. I'm afraid.
We've been running together. You ain't afraid to take what you want.
Right.
I guess what I'm wondering is...
Didn't anybody tell you that raiders run this town? Too late now, shut that little mouth. I got no problem.
In a world like this?
Yeah. You ask me, this whole damn world is here just to tear. Most folks are too stupid to realize it. They struggle every day until...
Give me what you got. I won't say it again.
They're idiots, Gage.
That's what I mean. They don't get it. But then some folks are too aware, you know?
Uh-huh.
And so they decide they're gonna have it all. In fact, if they can take it from others, fucking raiders. They get so greedy, so...
Turn out your pockets, don't hold nothing back. Arguing will get you killed, so don't give me no
black. And what about you, Gage?
As far as I'm concerned, all these people.
Sure.
You and me, though. Don't know about you, but I have. Mm-hmm. They were pushovers. One day, I'm watching, so I bail.
Give me what you got. You listening to me?
That.
The hell it was. I bounced around. I was a runner first when the raiders came through. Didn't take long before I.
Right.
Next time a gang came, running with you now.
Give me what you got. Ain't no chance you're gonna walk away.
I feel like you should be laying on a couch while I take notes,
man.
And then.
Yeah,
if that's a joke,
yeah.
I'm just saying.
Say,
it feels like you get it.
That was so good.
Whatever you've been through,
I love that.
You can relate. Good to have some. Anyway.
Are that? Okay.
Hey.
Ladies and gentlemen, there can be no more doubt. If you had any
good,
questions,
I don't know,
you can now rest assured that our overboss is a badass.
Leaving us hanging? Got a
little of everything. I don't know what the overboss has planned next, but man, get behind her or get the hell out of her way. It's Red Eye here, running Raider. You love it,
find him.
You know it.
Tams and other sweet treats. Get them while they last.
The Raiders
Who
keep
wants
talking
some
about.
Good
Do you want a purr? I want a purr. We'll be back.